Inomelae Kogi West. Mr. President, I start by saying that this budget, as presented by the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, is a budget that Nigerians and the Parliament needs to be sorry about. Before I go to the meat of the budget, Mr. President, we'll have to look at the state of our economy vis-a-vis the provisions stipulated in the budget therein. Mr. President, as I speak to the Parliament this afternoon, the federal government has spent $41 billion to cushion and stabilize the naira. $41 billion have been spent by the federal government to maintain, cushion, and stabilize the dollar. How long shall we continue in sin and ask grace to abound, Mr. President? I bring also to the attention of the Parliament that we no longer have enough foreign reserve to continue to cushion the effects of devaluation of the naira. Mr. President, the price of crude have dropped to 50 from 60. This is very significant and makes the projection price of crude oil in the 2019 budget unrealizable and unrealistic. Mr. President, there's a drop in the internally generated revenue of federal government. My respected colleagues, there is a drop in the revenue of Nigerian customs. Federal government have no money again to subsidize fuel subsidy. In the midst of all this outrageously calamitous situation, Mr. President, how do we fund the 2019 budget? Are we going to fund the budget based on daily contribution? Are we going to borrow again, Mr. President? These are questions begging for answers. I want to announce to Nigerians, despite the hypocrisy of the federal government, despite the lies in this budget, I prophesy to you, Mr. President, and to Nigerians, that the federal government will soon deregulate. Mr. President, inflation is on the rise. Unemployment is in the increase. Yet we have a budget that have nothing for the poor masses of this country. I challenge the proponents of the 2019 budget. I challenge those who support everything presented by the executive to tell me where in the 2019 budget has any provision been made for the Talakawas? Where in the 2019 budget is there any provision for the have-nots, the unemployed, and the poor masses of the Federal Republic of Nigeria? Mr. President, as I speak, there is no longer foreign investment in Nigeria. And I announce to you, Mr. President, with all these indices and yardstick, by the end of May, except there is a miracle, dollar will rise to 500 naira to $1. Because we have depleted our foreign reserve, we are a chartered borrowing nation. Mr. President, upon the announcement of Muhammadu Buhari as the winner of the election.
Point of order, Senator.
to say that as I speak, after the announcement of Muhammadu Buhari as the president-elect of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, the stock market have lost over 300 billion. And as I speak, Mr. President, as I speak to you, Mr. President, it is my turn to speak, and I expect that my colleagues will observe decorum and speak when their time comes. Mr. President, I want to state that there will be devaluation of the naira. We cannot, as a nation, be borrowing again to fund the 2019 budget. Mr. President, our external debt, as I speak today, is $23 billion, the highest in the history of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Not under the military government do we have this type of borrowing. Our local debt today is over $20 billion. That is to say that the Federal Republic of Nigeria today is owing over $40 billion, with about 60% of this amount is incurred under the administration in question. Mr. President, I also give this vantage information. I also give this vantage information to this Senate, Mr. President, that already there is a plan to write you, or write the Senate through you, where another $12 billion is about to be borrowed to service Port Harcourt, Maiduguri rail project. If that comes to the Senate, Mr. President, I hope when Senator Yayi will be speaking and we are interrupting him, you will not call us to question. This Senate is a responsible Senate. I have the floor. I should be allowed to make my remarks. You can counter me when you have the right to speak. Finally, Mr. President, if federal government succeeds in a matter of few weeks to send that request of $12 billion to service Port Harcourt Maiduguri rail project, our borrowing as a nation will be close to $60 billion. Then we are now going to borrow again to indebt, to put generations yet unborn in danger. And all these monies we have borrowed, Mr. President, I want to ask that let my colleagues who are hell-bent on supporting anything executive tell this Senate, what have we benefited from the over $16 billion?
All right. Okay, Senator Jim. All right, Senator. Okay, Senator Shiu. Okay, say point of order, Senator.